People use energy when we are physically active, but we also use energy when we are resting quietly. In fact, quiet metabolic activities account for the largest share of most people's energy expenditures. About two-thirds of the energy the average person expends in a day supports body's basal metabolism. Metabolic activities include the lungs inhaling and exhaling air, the bone marrow making new red blood cells, the heart beating 100,000 times a day, and the kidneys filtering waste. In short, they support all the basic processes of life. Your metabolism can play a role in weight gain by influencing the amount of energy your body needs at any given point. Excess energy is then stored as fat. In this video, we will be talking about some of the factors that affect basal metabolic rate. Age. The metabolic rate of a young child is almost double that of an adult person due to rapid synthesis of cellular materials and growth of the body. Metabolism peaks at 10 years of age and minimum at old age. BMR begins to decrease in early adulthood by about 2% per decade as growth and development cease. Height. If two people weigh the same, the taller, thinner person will have the faster metabolic rate because there is greater skin surface through which heat is lost by radiation in proportion to the body's volume. Let's take a look at these structures to understand how height influences basal metabolic rate. Each of these structures is made of 8 blocks. They weigh the same, but they are arranged differently. The short, wide structure has 24 sides exposed, and the tall, thin one has 34. Because the tall, thin structure has greater surface area, it will lose more heat, thus expend more energy than the short, wide one. Pregnancy. Metabolic changes during pregnancy are among the many adjustments the mother's organs make to meet the requirements created by the increase in her own breast, genital tissues, and the growth of the fetus. In addition, reserves must be established to meet the demands that will be put on her body during pregnancy, delivery, and post-delivery period. Breastfeeding or lactation. During lactation, the basal metabolic rate also increases because of milk production. Body composition and gender. The more muscle tissue or lean tissue in the body will contribute to a higher BMR because muscles require more energy to function than fat. The more muscle tissues you carry, the more energy your body needs just to exist, which is also a reason why males usually have higher BMR compared to women because women have higher proportion of body fat compared to men. Fever. Fever raises BMR by 7% for each degree Fahrenheit. During infection or illness, BMR raises because the body has to work harder to build new tissues and to create an immune response. Environmental temperature. If temperature is very low or very high, the body has to work harder to maintain its normal body temperature, which in turn increases the BMR. Crash dieting, fasting, or starvation. Eating too few kilocalories encourages the body to slow down the metabolism to conserve energy. BMR can drop by up to 15%, and if the lean muscle tissue is also lost, this further reduces BMR. Malnutrition. Malnutrition also lowers the BMR because during malnutrition, BMR slows down to conserve energy and protect vital organs. Hormones. The BMR is controlled by the nervous and the hormonal systems. Hormonal imbalances can influence how quickly or slowly the body burns kilocalories. Hormonal imbalances such as hypo and hyperthyroidism by the thyroid hormone thyroxine, for example, can speed up or slow down the BMR. Premenstrual hormones also slightly raise the BMR. Smoking. Cigarette smoking increases a person's metabolic rate slightly by forcing the heart to beat faster. Regular smoking increases the heart rate, which causes extra stress on the heart and plays a role in heart disease, the most common cause of smoking-related death. Caffeine. There are evidences that prove that caffeine does increase metabolism. This is due to the action of caffeine that stimulates your nervous system, which sends direct signals to the fat cells telling them to break down fat, When the blood levels of hormone epinephrine or adrenaline is increased, caffeine promotes the release of fatty acids from fat tissues. This may sound good, and you may think that caffeine can help you lose weight. However, studies have shown that caffeine can boost your metabolism in the short term. This effect is diminished in long-term coffee drinkers due to tolerance. Although metabolism can play a role in weight gain, it isn't the slow metabolism to be blamed for gaining weight, because better food choices and exercise have the biggest impact. One way to increase BMR is to participate in endurance and strength training activities regularly to maximize lean body mass.